listen to my horoscope. It says that I'm way outgoing, a great friend to all my gal pals, and I'm gonna meet a handsome prince who will carry me off on his horse.
Right, Chloe. Like, you touch a horse.
I would if there was a prince on it.
It also says you're a major drama queen.
That is so untrue. I think I just had an out-of-the-blue arterial explosion.
Well, mine says I'm strong, sensitive, and a little secretive. And there's a super scorching guy in my future who's so perfect for yours truly.
Check this out. Music is my thing, and my style is off the hook. I can't commit to any one guy. When you're this gorgeous, why should you? And I'm... Yeah, right. Like, they know what they're talking about. This magazine bites.
A control freak? Wow, Sasha. That's practically psychic.
I got it! I got it!
The latest crash CD?
Better. I got the student internship.
The one at Your Thing magazine?
You are looking at the new assistant to Miss Birdine Maxwell, editor-in-chief.
Rockin'!
Jade, you get to go to all the runway shows? And watch supermodel meltdowns?
And get free passes to all the happening concerts?
I sure hope so.
Can you believe it? It's my total biggest dream, and it's coming true.
Did you see what she was wearing?
911, mean girl alert. Those two things are called Kirstie and Casey. But everyone at Styles High calls them the Tweevils, because they're twins and seriously evil. Casey's bandage, it's the remains of her third nose job. Flying objects are just drawn to it.
Well, look who's here.
The fashion freaks.
Yeah.
Whatever.
Yo, Chloe, I spy your prince coming.
That's Cameron.
He's kind of shy. You know, the strong, silent type we met in second grade. He's way cute and everything, but I still can't figure him out.
Check this out!
Dylan, watch out!
My new ensemble!
My new nose!
Are you okay?
Hey! In case you didn't notice, my outfit is totally trashed!
Don't freak. It was an accident.
Don't tell me not to freak, you... you skater boy!
Ooh, that's gotta hurt.
Ow, 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 ow!
Rewind?
Go for it.
Sweet!
Can I try?
Are you sure you can handle it? Awesome moves, Chloe.
Thanks, Cameron. I've got a lot of cool moves. I mean, on the skateboard? You know, ollies and donkey kicks, 720s and stuff.
Yeah. Hey, you think you could teach me a 720 sometime?
Yeah, sure. Whatever.
Cool. Whatever.
Hey, guys, did you hear? Jade's going to be working at Your Thing magazine for the whole summer.
Awesome! Hey, what's your thing?
Do you know you are talking to the founder, president, editor-in-chief, queen of fashion? You ridiculous, incompetent moron. I want a dozen pair of those peony pink pumps here tomorrow, size 11, and don't give me any more of your lame excuses that you don't have my size! Mother of pink! And what are you supposed to be?
I'm Jade, your new student intern. I just want to tell you I am so psyched to be working here with you and your thing.
I've got a ton of ideas for the magazine.
Oh, really?
I was thinking that maybe we could do a column on street trends, see what's taking off at clubs, do a quiz fest.
Stop! Just so we understand each other, I come up with the ideas. Your thing is my magazine. You work for me, and your title is nothing.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to...
Ah, my other interns. Two lovely girls.
Newsflash. This day is not going well.
Pink. My favorite color. Here's your first assignment. And this is what I want you girls to do. Now get busy. Royale and I have some shoe shopping to do, don't we, my little bitty baby boy? Oh, mommy loves her little babies.
Neato! It's a fashion assignment. I need you guys to model for me.
Well, okay.
Oh, Kirstie, it's beautiful. Yeah, give me a supermodel smile. Oh, gorgeous. A little pout. Oh, that was great. Okay, work it. Good. Okay, okay. Jade's turn. Wait a sec. Oh, perfection.
Woo! I am just exhausted from all that work.
Wow, this is a lot for one person. Maybe you guys could help me out?
Sorry, N-O-P.
N-O-P? Not our problem.
Working overtime. You got a lot of things that you gotta do. Working day and night. Feel like you never stop. Working overtime. All you really need is a little more time to get it right. Working overtime. That's when it feels like just too much. Working overtime.
Can you believe Berdine? Everything about her is, like, so plastic.
Totally. She reminds me of that fashion doll that you used to hit me with when we were three.
Okay, girls. Show me the fashion do's and don'ts assignment.
Do's?
Don'ts.
Perfection!
Maybe they're right. I'm nothing but one big fashion don't.
Jade, how's it going?
Totally terrible, Angel. Bertine is so mean. She hates me, and guess who I have to work with? The Tweevils.
Wow, that's really awful, but try to hang in there. This is your dream, remember?
Yeah, you're right. This is my dream. You're such a good friend, Angel. Thanks.
No problem, Cool Cat. I'll check in with you later, okay?
Oh, Berdine is so meany-weeny.
And Kirsty and Casey are so nasty-wasty.
There you are. Now, where's my mail?
It's right here. You have some really rockin' invitations. Look how many. There's one from that...
Junk, junk, junk. More junk. Mother of Pink. Don't you know junk mail when you see it? I'm wearing my new pumps today, so get these old ones polished. And where's my lunch already? Hello? What? What do you mean sales of your thing have dropped? Well, that's impossible! What?
Do you guys know what Berdine likes for lunch?
Sure, we'll phone in the order.
But it's your turn to pick it up from the deli.
Okay, I guess these will have to wait till later.
Carbs!
What are you trying to do? Kill me? Make me fat? I don't eat greens!
But I...
Spare me your excuses. You are fired. Hear me? Fired! And not only will you never, ever work at this magazine again, you will never, ever work at any magazine. Am I making myself quite clear? You are fired for life. In fact, even your children and your grandchildren are fired! Fired! Fired!
My life is so over. It's so unfair. All my hopes and dreams destroyed in 3 hours.
Don't worry, Cool Cat. Everything will work out. You have way too much talent not to make it.
Jade, you're a fashion superhero. Berdine's the one who's majorly clueless, not you.
You guys really think so?
Totally. Now, come on, people. It's time for some serious cheer up.
Shopping!
Ain't nothing stopping us.
Yeah, yeah.
It's a girl thing. Just having a little fun.
Thanks, guys, for really being there for me. You're the best.
No prob.
That's what best friends are for.
Girlfriend 411. Major eyesores ahead.
Well, well, if it isn't Jade and her little band of fashion faux pas.
Faux pas? Parlez-vous français?
Perfectamente. So, Jade, what are you gonna do now that your career in fashion is, like, so over?
Her career isn't so over. It's just beginning.
Oh, really? As a fast food delivery girl?
Ow! My nose! Cool Cat, you wouldn't have learned a thing at this lame-o magazine.
So yesterday. You know, we should really have our own magazine.
Pretty Princess? That's a scorching idea.
It is? Totally. I could write an advice column. Dear Chloe, fashion emergency. And I can write about trends. Where to hang, where to work it, and where to learn the latest poses.
And I can be the editor.
Funny Boo.
The music editor. I'd review what's down and slamming and gets everybody jamming.
And I'd be the most cutting-edge
lifestyle editor!
Wait a sec. Are you guys thinking what I'm thinking?
I am so thinking what you're thinking.
You're kidding, right?
No way kidding.
Let's start our own teen magazine!
Wait! Reality check? What about an office? No way we can afford one. I'll have to babysit every night, even on weekends. And
chill, Angel. Let me work it.
Here we are!
Love it!
Feel it!
Hate it!
Huh?
It's Berdine's building. If she sees me, I'm beyond dead.
Chill. We got your back.
I am so glad to be out of there.
What's with the crown thing?
Berdine likes to think of herself as the reigning queen of fashion.
More like the queen of mean.
Miss Queen Berdine is going down.
Okay, guys, this is it. Get ready to feast your eyes on the most totally slamming loft in all downtown. Sasha, you can't be serious.
Okay, so the place needs a little makeover.
Okay, a serious makeover.
This place is so beyond help.
Yo, drama mama, snap out of it. We survived 7th grade. We can survive this. A little primo and paint.
Relocate a few shelves.
Dramatize the area over here.
Set up a computer bank.
And girlfriends, we're happening. Let's hit it!
If your magazine's half as good as your office, it's gonna be great.
And hey, if you need me to attend any parties with supermodels, my cell's on 24/7.
Goodbye, Dylan!
Ew!
Ew! What an interesting artifact. They're probably circa 1988.
They're Berdine's totally twisted idea of fashion. She gave them to me to get polished, and I forgot to give them back.
At least we'll never show anything that vomititious in our magazine.
You losers are starting a magazine?
What's it about? How to be a loser?
No, it's a fashion magazine.
With the way you spazzes dress?
What are you gonna call it? Teen Hurl?
Yeah! Just wait till Berdine finds out you guys are trying to rip off your thing.
Our thing won't be anything like your thing.
Sorry we won't be around to make you get fired in less than a day, but I'm sure you'll mess things up all by yourself.
Yeah, and then you'll all have to fire each other.
Good one, Casey!
Excuse us, but we have work to do.
And you have dry cleaning to do.
Excuse me?
The wet paint?
You brats! You totally set me up!
Come on, Casey, let's get out of here before they do something to me!
I never want to see those girls again.
Then avoid the bathroom between 1:30 and 2. That's their Disperdine Fest.
That's very interesting. Oh, pretty princess, what are you thinking?
I think I have a zit under here.
Hot it!
My nose job isn't as bad as Berdine's, is it?
Are you kidding? Hers is all pointy and bony, like an icky bird beak.
Oh, do you think Birdface has had other work done?
Totally. I bet she's had lipo and a facelift and her lips silicone. Ugh, that's why they look like big, fat, rotting sausages.
How old do you think she is?
She is so ancient, at least 30. It was her! I'd know those classic pink pumps anywhere. I bet she heard everything. What are we gonna do?
Cry?
You totally even the score.
Mission accomplished.
Well?
We are like so sorry. We didn't mean any of those things that we said.
We totally think that your lips look like big, fat, rotting sausages.
Or that you have a pointy, bony, icky bird beak nose.
And that you're 30.
30? You think I'm 30?
My nose. Please don't hurt my nose.
Wrong shoes!
Uh-oh.
Run for it!
Any ideas on what to call our fab new magazine?
How about Sasha?
You guys, I was only playing with you. We need something styling.
With attitude.
That's us.
First article completed. Mean girls busted. Don't get mad, get even.
You brats.
Brats.
That's what Berdine and the Tweevils call us.
So we make it our own.
Give it some attitude.
But maybe a little too much attitude.
I got it. Hold on.
Brats!
Awesome! Let's think about our first major scoop.
Say no more. I just happen to have saved all those invites Berdine made me toss.
You are not gonna believe this. Super stylin' fashion reporter Jade scoops the biggest scoop of all scoops ever. Invitations to the exclusive opening of Pins, the most hap new punk rock club, and to the Save the Universe benefit concert.
No way!
Every rock star in the world is gonna be there. All expense paid, accommodations included, on a private jet and a 5-star luxury hotel suite in London!
We rock!
We're hot!
We're the girls with a passion for fashion.
And we're going to London. I can't believe this is really happening. Our very own magazine.
You better believe it.
This trip is going to be so awesome, Cameron.
Maybe we can see Big Ben together.
Sure, if we have time.
Excuse me, but I do believe you're in my seat.
Oops. Sorry. My mistake.
Allow me to introduce myself. I'm Nigel Forrester, the 9th Duke of Wessex.
Hottie alert. My horoscope did say a handsome prince would carry me away on a horse, but a cute duke on a private jet works for me. And I'm Chloe. Nice to meet you.
Huh. Relax, dude. It's only a 10-hour flight. Thanks, Dillman.
Pins is supposed to be the most super stylin' punk club ever. And the benefit concert is gonna be scorching. Every major rock star will be there. Poor Berdine. She's so clueless. She has no idea she threw out the party invitations of the year.
Give me that, you ugly furball!
Idiot interns, how dare you let me let Jade throw out the invitations of the year?
But we weren't even in the office.
Yeah!
Spare me your lame excuses. Your thing will not be outscooped by that amateur Bratz magazine, or I'll have you two hung upside down by your shoe straps. Now, how come my suitcases aren't packed already? Hurry up, chop, chop.
Quit it, you little rat!
Ladies and gentlemen, please fasten your seatbelts. We're about to begin our descent into London Heathrow International Airport.
England, here we come.
Look, I can see Big Ben.
If I may be so bold, it would be an honor to show you Big Ben tomorrow.
Really?
Check it.
Love it.
Man, this lobby is off the hook.
Totally.
Here it is. Welcome to the Q Hotel Superstorling Supremo Suite.
Wow, this place is slamming.
Check this out.
Can you believe this place?
Feel it.
Wow, check out the view.
Forget the view. Let's scoop this stylin' city.
Yes!
London, here we come.
Living it up, yeah, we're gonna have fun.
And I will scope out the 10 best places to find the cutest guys. Cameron and Dillon are going to cover sports and entertainment.
And Jade and I will scoop the London fashion scene. I've already mapped out all the super stylin' places I want to go today.
Sasha, you mean where we want to go?
Barnaby Street's not on here.
Chill, Coquette. We'll get to it.
Fine.
Come on, pretty princess. Let's hit the London Eye. It's supposed to be London's hottest hangout.
I am so there.
That must be my mother. Again. Mom, I am not wearing those rubber boots you snuck in my suitcase. Nigel, hi. Oh my gosh, it's him!
Talk, girl.
Of course I remember you. Right now? Sure, I'm not doing anything. See you in 10. Oh no, I've got a date with Nigel and only 5 minutes to accessorize!
Angel, the London Eye?
We'll check it out in the morning, okay?
Sure.
Thanks, Yaz. You rock.
Oh, I've got a nosebleed!
Cork it.
Mother of Pink, would you please control your fat mutt?
Excuse me, but your pathetic hairy rat is attacking my Ozzy.
Stuff it, Tubbo.
Come on, Ozzy. Let's leave the nasty woman and her mongrel alone. Sit.
Royale, sit. Mother of Pink!
Thank you for the corsage, Nigel. It's beautiful.
Not nearly as beautiful as you, my pretty princess. You know, I don't believe I've ever felt this way about a girl before.
Nigel, we just met.
What, you don't believe in love at first sight? Ah, a waltz. Shall we dance?
Reality check. Have I really found my Prince Charming?
Man, how do the Brits channel surf with only 5 TV channels?
Chloe, how was your date with Prince Charming?
Prince Charming?
Tell us everything.
Spill it.
It was amazing. We went to a really romantic restaurant, had a perfect dinner, and then we waltzed.
Well, I'm glad you had a good time. We're still on for the Eye tomorrow morning, right?
Oh, maybe later in the day. Nigel invited me to his family's castle. And, well, when he called me his pretty princess, I just couldn't say no.
Pretty princess?
Nigel, your place is so awesome.
Come now, darling. Keep your eye on the ball.
Just a sec. Oh, hi, Yasmin. What's up?
What's up? It's almost 4:00. You were supposed to meet me here at 3 to go check out the London Eye.
Oh, Yaz, I am so sorry. I completely spaced. I can probably make it in an hour or two.
Forget it. I'll do the story all by myself. Later.
Hi, cutie. Are you lost?
Oh, your name's Ozzy. You're a sweetie, aren't you, Ozzy? I know just how you feel. I've lost my best friend, too.
Come on, sweetie. Let's go before we get soaked.
Hey, Georgie girl. I've got to do a movie review for the hot new Bratz magazine. Wanna come?
Okay. What would you like to see?
What about Zombie Crusher 2? Man, Zombie Crusher 1 was so tight! That part where the head exploded was like just, oh man, it was just gross!
Dean Maxwell, the founder, president, editor-in-chief of Your Thing magazine and the reigning queen of fashion, and I demand my royal suite.
No!
Mother of Pink, you call this a room?
for a dog, maybe.
Come on, Bunny Boo, give me some camera time.
Uh-oh, no more memory.
But I haven't even taken one shot.
You will. Now let's jam. I plan the whole day and I don't want to miss our magazine deadline.
You plan the whole day without consulting me?
Jade, will you chill already? I know what I'm doing.
Right. Coolest landmarks. Hitch a ride on the world's largest observation wheel.
Guys, I'm so glad you're here. Chloe's totally bailed on me. I found the cutest little... dog?
Can you believe those fashion challenge brats named a magazine after themselves?
Those brazen brats will pay for this. All of this! Stealing our room, daring to start a rival fashion magazine, having the audacity to try to outscoop us! Pay attention to me when I'm ranting. I will get those girls and put their rotten little magazine out of business, even if it kills you! They cannot and will not succeed. Do you understand? And what is that horrible smell of smoke? Oh, mother of pink!
I'm going to order a pot of tea.
Chloe, you hate tea? And what's with your voice?
I've grown quite fond of...
Right.
One pot of tea, please.
As I was saying, croquet requires intense concentration. Isn't that true, pretty princess?
I don't know. I've never played.
Huh?
Nigel, Yasmin's nickname is also Pretty Princess.
Really? I'd say you're more of a... Peaches.
Peaches?
I'll see you tomorrow, Pretty Princess. Cheerio, Peaches.
Cheerio.
See you tomorrow, Nigel. Isn't he awesome?
Totally awesome.
Later. Cool Cat, if you got something to say to me, say it.
Fine. You are the biggest, bossiest control freak I've ever met. You're even worse than Bertine.
Come on, guys, chill.
Like, you know what's going on? You haven't even been around.
No kidding. Yasmin's had to cover every hotspot by herself.
Yasmin doesn't mind.
Yes, I do. I mean, next thing you know, you'll be telling us you can't make the opening of pins.
Oh, I totally spaced. Nigel's brother's giving a dinner party tomorrow, and I promised I'd go.
One of the main reasons we came to London was to get that scoop for our new magazine.
911 communication breakdown. How can I expect even my best friends to understand? No one knows the pain, the agony I'm going through. Torn between my very first Prince Charming, I mean Duke Charming, and my three best friends forever. What's a teenage drama queen to do?
Bad news, guys. Bertine and the Tweevils are here. What's going on? Girl stuff.
Sometimes I feel like I'm the only one who gets me. It doesn't seem to matter what I say.
Jade's pictures. Wow, they're super stylish. Don't get me at all.
Nigel, hi. You remember Sasha?
Hey. Whatever.
My friends are covering the opening of this happening new punk rock club for our magazine. We could go there after the dinner party.
We'll discuss it later. Now hurry up and get dressed. We don't want to be late.
I am dressed.
Dressed? Darling, you can't be serious. Surely you must have something that's a little more elegant and understated. You know, like what those two lovely girls eavesdropping outside your door are wearing.
What?
Ow! My nose!
Oh, hi. We were just passing by.
When you became glued to our door?
It's really him! Nigel Forrester, Duke of Lessex!
Correction, I'm Nigel Forrester, the 9th Duke of Wessex.
I like so like your tie.
And I like so love your taste.
Break it up, sisters. Mutual admiration time is over.
I hardly think such rude behavior was called for. Especially since those girls were rather attractive.
Nigel?
But not as attractive as you, my pretty princess. Now, tally on, we really must be going.
Ew!
Hey, Cool Cat, I've been working on a photo layout and I need your opinion.
Our layout?
Bunny Boo, you used all my pictures. Yours were way better.
Thanks.
I'm sorry about everything.
That's okay, Sasha.
Apology accepted.
Best friends again?
Forever.
Did I miss something?
Come on, we gotta look totally punkalicious for the opening of pins.
Are you thinking what I'm thinking?
Shopping!
Look around, head for the underground, getting ready to rock. So punk out, that's what it's all about, we're at the party spot. Let's keep it pretty.
In case you've forgotten, there's a party inside.
I was just taking five. You know, the pins opening starts at...
Oh, really, Chloe? I wouldn't be caught dead at some tacky punk rock club. I mean, it's so low class.
I don't think so. Punk clubs rule. Besides, I'm just hanging out with my friends.
Those misfits. Oh, come now, pretty princess. They're so uncouth.
You just don't get them, you royal jerk!
And you, pretty princess, are way out of line!
Stop calling me pretty princess! My friends call me Angel.
Dookie, there you are! This balcony is, like, so beautiful.
Not nearly as beautiful as you, my pretty princess. You know, I don't believe I've ever felt this way about a girl before.
Dookie, we've just met!
You don't believe in love at first sight?
Look, I can see Big Ben! Ah!
Cheerio!
Only you can be the one. Even though I know you're gone. Only you can fix my heart.
Something?
My shoe. You found it.
Hold on, Angel.
Dylan, you gotta take pictures of guys as well as girls. Our readers will want to see both.
Got it!
Hi, guys.
Chloe!
Guys, I've had an over-the-top emotional breakthrough. These past few days, I haven't been true to myself or to you. I am so sorry. I can totally understand if you never want to talk to me again.
Girls, I think our resident drama mama is back.
Wow, you guys look so pretty and punk.
Thanks. This is what we're wearing to the opening of Pins tonight.
And Angel, so are you.
I can't believe it! You got that for me?
You know, Yasmin, there really is only one pretty princess.
And there's only one Angel.
Best friends.
Forever.
They're doing it again.
So, do we have a club to scoop or what?
Yeah!
Hi, Six with Bratz? I mean, Your Thing Magazine?
I demand that you have these brats arrested for impersonation.
Call the police.
No!
Chop chop!
Yep.
found Ozzy.
Major celebrity sighting.
Everybody, just act cool.
Emergency huddle.
Oh my gosh, no way. It's Byron Powell, the judge from America Rocks.
My favorite show. Chill, he's coming this way.
I've been worried sick about him.
You're his owner?
Mother of Pink. Arrest them. I want the whole lot of them handcuffed and...
Yeah.
It's that absolutely horrific woman from the plane. Follow me. I brought a few friends. You do realize, Edgar, that those dreadful ladies are in gross violation of the dress code? Punk doesn't mix with pink.
Do you know who I am? You can't do this. I am Bernine Maxwell, the founder, president, editor-in-chief.
Strike one for the Bratz. Rocking! Awesome!
So how can I reward you for taking care of Ozzy?
How about an interview for a new teen magazine?
You know, I just signed Crash. They're headlining the Save the Universe benefit concert tomorrow night.
We've got tickets.
Then how would you like backstage passes and an interview with me after the show?
Yes! Ah! Yes!
Shall we dance?
Party last night at Pins was totally awesome.
Yeah, I was so all over that dance floor.
And I met a mysterious man, just like my horoscope said. Can you believe it was Byron Powell, the mean judge from America Rocks?
Your interview with him is gonna rock.
Well, my horoscope said a handsome prince would sweep me away on a horse. More like I kissed a duke and he turned into a frog.
Cheer up, Chloe, because tonight, Bratz Magazine hits the Save the Universe concert.
And thanks to Yasmin, we've also got backstage passes.
Mother of Pink, those rotten little brats scooped us on that stupid punk rock club last night, and now they're going to scoop us on the Save the Universe concert. If I don't get tickets ASAP for that sold-out concert, I'll hang both of you by your ears from the top of Big Ben.
Ow!
Got it. Now chop chop!
Not my mother again.
Mom.
Oh, hi, Cameron. We were just leaving for Hyde Park.
Okay. See you there.
Hot date, Angel?
No, it was just Cameron.
Hey, pretty princess. The concert tickets are in a safe place, right? I don't want Bernine or those Tweedles to get their thieving hands on them.
Trust me, Bunny Boo. I've got them stashed.
Well, the suite is like amazing. Look at all this neat stuff. Yeah. Oh, it's nice.
Give it to me. I saw it first.
No, not me. Oh, it's mine.
It's alive. Casey, turn it off.
Yes.
Awesome.
Your turn, Cameron.
Got it. Hey, Chloe, you believe in love at first sight?
After Nigel, I'm not so sure. Come on, let's go hang with the others.
Let's get to it, everybody do it. Hey, everybody have some fun. Hey, now!
We better find those tickets before old Birdface kills us.
Yeah, because it'll be really hard to find them if we're dead.
Ooh, this jacket is, like, so cute.
Ew, put it down. It's got Bratz cooties. Bingo!
lives are like so not over.
We're going to live!
They're back! Quick, hide!
Mind if I hang out here while room service cleans my suite?
If you promise to be quiet, I have to work on questions for my interview with Byron Powell.
Hey, what time does the concert start? I want to make sure I have major mirror time to get ready.
I'll check. Oh my gosh, the tickets are gone!
This concert is my dream come true. Every jam and rock band in the world is gonna be there.
And we're gonna meet them all backstage, thanks to Yasmin.
This scoop is gonna put Bratz Magazine on the map.
I know I hid them in my jacket. Think for me, Dylan. I can't believe this is happening. What am I going to do? I know. I'll find Byron. He'll get us in. Stay here and cover for me, okay? And don't tell anyone I lost the tickets.
They'll have to hang me by my thumbs and force me to use generic shampoo.
I'll be back in a flash. So needs the scoop. I've just got to find Byron. Byron, open up. It's me, Yasmin. I need to talk to Byron Powell. It's an emergency. My life is so over.
Stop, don't move. Here's some dirty laundry.
Ew, it's the Bratz used underwear.
Cootie alert! Ew!
Let's get to the concert early so we can hang with the bands before they go on.
Hey, guys.
Where's Yasmin?
Oh, she had to, go out.
Really? Where?
Bowling.
Bowling? Not!
You're hiding something, aren't you?
Me? No way. Nothing to hide. So, what's new? Read any good books lately?
Ticklefest!
Tell us. Spill it.
Okay. I confess. Yasmin lost the concert tickets and is out trying to get new passes.
Those tickets cannot be gone. We've gotta find them. My article depends on it. I told her to put those tickets in a safe place.
She said she did.
Well, not safe enough. Chill, Bunny Boo. Yas is our friend. We gotta hear her side of the story. You're right, Angel.
So what if you don't stalk them? When are you idiots going to get the message?
Mission accomplished.
My nose is going to fall off.
Ugh, you and your bad nose jobs.
Perfection. Your Thing Magazine is going to leave Bratz Magazine in the dust. Bratz, your careers are over.
I bet everyone is going to be at that concert.
And all eyes will be on me. Which is why you two are going to turn me into a hipster.
The tickets have got to be around here somewhere.
What? Dylan, how could you?
Sorry, but they tickled it out of me.
Pretty princess, why didn't you want to tell us?
Oh, cool cat. I was afraid to let you guys and the magazine down.
Yasmin, tickets or no tickets, we still love you.
Really?
Of course. Our friendship is way more important than some concert.
How do I look? Can you smell the surf and sand inside me?
For Dean Maxwell, it's Honolulu you.
Mother of Pink, it's Honolulu me.
The bouncer said only bands were allowed in.
Yo, yes. What's that on your shoe?
Ew!
Why does that gross bandage look so familiar?
Tweedles!
You didn't lose the tickets. Those seriously evil twins got in here and stole them.
Oh, no. We'll never get the tickets back now. We might as well give up and go home and forget all our dreams and get Dad in jobs where they make you work under those awful fluorescent lights and no amount of makeup can make you look good in those and...
Well, no way am I gonna let Berdine and the Tweevils destroy my dream again.
You mean our dream, Cool Cat. Nothing's gonna stop us from launching Bratz Magazine.
So what are we gonna do?
Yasmin, did you say they only let rock bands into the concert?
Are you thinking what I'm thinking?
Let's become
a rock band!
Look, people, we got less than 4 hours to put together a slamming song and convince that bouncer that we're the real thing.
4 hours? We'll never make it!
Chill, Angel. My horoscope said music is my thing, and I know how to make it happen. Here's the plan. I'll work out the moves. Jade, you're in charge of wardrobe. On it. Chloe and Yasmin, you write the song.
Awesome.
Rockin'.
I'll be your roadie, and I'll be your lead singer. Backup singer? Lip syncer?
Actually, Dylan, you belong behind the camera.
Paparazzi? Hot! So what are you gonna call yourselves?
What about Sasha's Angels?
Hold on, Angels, rock. What about Rock Angels?
What about Bratz Rock Angels?
Love it!
Yes, Bratz Rock Angels!
Come on, Bratz Rock Angels. Let's move it and groove it.
We're all tied and feeling
something?
Oh, no! Guitars!
Oh, my gosh! We'll never get them in time for the concert. The bouncer won't let us in. We won't get our backstage exclusive or interview with Byron Powell. Our premiere issue of Bratz Magazine will tank, and I'll have to go camping with my parents and sing Elvis songs!
Hey, guys! Look what we scored at the flea market.
Bratz Rock Angels, hit it!
Guys rock!
Oh, yeah!
Are you too sure this is the hot new dance?
Oh, yeah. Everyone at school is, like, so doing it. Right, Casey?
Yeah!
Now follow us!
I didn't know you guys could play guitars like that.
There's a lot of things you don't know about us.
Yeah, Sasha here. See you in a few. Our limo is waiting.
Limo!
It's time for the Bratz Rock Angels to rock the world.
Bratz Rock Angels, over here. This one's for the cover of Bratz Magazine.
Dookie, what are you doing here?
Oh, you know, just thought I'd venture out to sneer at the exploits of the masses.
Araya.
Nigel Forrester, the ninth Duke of Wessex.
As I'm sure you know, I'm Berdine Maxwell, the founder, president, and editor-in-chief of Your Thing magazine and the reigning queen of fashion.
Wow! Look, queen, whoever you are, get yourself a surfer dude. One my father's age.
Your father's age?
Man, you don't recognize the Bratz Rock Angels? They're the most styling hip new rock band. Come on, one more.
Keep Mr. Space Invader away from us, okay?
Hey!
We did it! We're in!
What do you mean, crash, crashed? Your band broke up?
Yeah, the band split. It's over for Crash. But I'm not ready to go solo.
This is absolutely, positively, an unmitigated disaster!
I feel terrible. This concert means so much to everyone.
Oh my gosh! You're Roxy, lead singer of Crash!
You were supposed to go on stage now! What are we gonna do? Can you girls sing?
You bet we can sing.
Are you ready? The Change the World Benefit Concert welcomes the Bratz Rock Angels!
Bratz! What are they doing up there? Get down, do you hear me? Get down!
Okay, lady, let's go.
I will have you arrested. Do you know who I am? Put me down!
Not our problem.
They're rocking hot and rocking your world. Give it up for the Bratz Rock Angels!
We know how to dare, we know how to dream. Tonight is the night, what we wanna be will be. We're gonna make it through. Let's conquer the fears, take every chance, hold back the tears. What we wanna be will be. We're gonna make it through. Out of our heads, into our hearts.
Rock Angels!
Feels so good.
And so that is how the girls with a passion for fashion launched Bratz, their very own teen magazine, and became rock stars.
The trip to London gave us so many awesome stories.
Bratz celebrity exclusive, Byron Powell, the ultimate judge.
You girls are absolutely positively the best band I've ever heard.
Inspiration for my first Bratz quiz. Is your boyfriend a royal jerk? Question one, does he diss your best friends?
Those misfits.
If your answer is yes,
dump him.
A super style and fashion scoop. Pretty and Punk, London's latest looks. As well as my very own do's and don'ts column.
Do's, don'ts. But the scoop of the century was how to make your own
rock band.
Let's hear it for Girl Power. Our magazine was a home run.
Like we said, flying objects are just drawn to it.
Berdine was so depressed, she ate a plateful of hamburgers with extra cheese and mayo.
Must destroy Bratz.
Of course she blamed our super style and success on the Tweevils. And the Tweevils had to pay the price.
Must destroy Bratz.
As for our careers as rock stars, Byron gave us a groovalicious recording contract.
Oh, you guys rock!
Roxy became our new best friend forever.
And we went on a worldwide tour.
And the Bratz Rock Angels zoomed to the top of the charts.
Oh, I almost forgot. We added one last super stylin' touch to our pad. The cover of our premiere issue of Bratz Magazine.
We're the girls with a passion for fashion.
And
we rock!
Check out these jamming tunes I got for our wildlife safari park.
Cool. The rockin' safari prints and toy parrots I ordered are on their way.
Where's Yasmin?
Library. She's stressing because she has a poem due Monday.
Poems are easy. Tell her not to sweat it. She'll get it.
Casey, quit grossing me out! I'm trying to hear what the Bratz are up to.
Look what I can do since I've had my new nose job.
Who are you taking to the party, Eaton?
I know who I want to ask, but I don't think she'll go out with me.
Dude, just follow my advice. I'll show you how to get your crush in a rush.
Hey, that's an awesome idea for a Bratz Magazine article.
Chloe's right. Eaton, here's your big op to finally write for our magazine.
Oh, cool. But she's not really a crush. She's just this really cute girl I like.
So who is she?
I'm not telling.
Oh, come on! Just spill it.
Nope. No way.
I can't believe Eaton is taking me to the party.
Hey, are you deaf? He's taking me to the party.
What makes you think he would ask someone as ugly as you?
You're just jealous because I am, like, so much prettier than you.
Stop it! Stop it!
Junk, junk, junk. More junk.
Welcome to greatestdates.com. You passed our stringent background check.
To meet a man.
I'm Eden's crush.
No, I'm Eden's crush.
No, he likes me because I'm, like, so blonde.
Well, he likes me because I, like, so know how to wear pink.
We'll see when Eden asks me out for that Bratz Magazine article on how to get a girl to go out with you.
That's the worst magazine idea I've ever heard. We'll do how to get a guy to go out with you.
Neato!
Your thing will outscoop that crummy little Bratz magazine once and for all.
Yeah!
Stylin'!
Oh, that must be the toy parrots.
Now that
That's what I call lifelike.
Lifelike! Lifelike!
Oh my gosh! They're alive!
Don't be ridiculous.
Ew!
They're real, all right.
So how are we supposed to write this article anyway?
Simple. We'll just copy everything from this book. The Loser's Guide to Dating, Dining, and Dumping.
Ooh, here's a chapter on flirting. Walk past a guy slowly and wink.
You idiot! You're supposed to wink with one eye at a time.
Hey! I'm not paying you nothing to hang out in the ladies' room.
Actually, we were just practicing our flirting technique for the article. Walk past boys and wink.
Well, you're not going to meet any boys in here!
She's right. We should be hanging out in the men's room.
Yeah!
See, I told you Birdface had a facelift. It's like so tight she could hardly wink.
The mail order company refuses to take the parrots back.
Hi, Eaton. Want some scorching parrots?
Scorching! Scorching!
No way. But wish me luck, because I'm ready to ask that girl out.
We don't think so. Makeover! Now you're ready.
Yes!
Dude, where are you going?
To ask that girl out.
Now you're ready. Except for two tiny things. This is for your ear, so I can coach you on the fine art of smooth-talking chicks.
I don't know, Dylan.
You want a date or not?
Oh, I forgot something. I'm gonna go back down.
Well, I forgot something too.
Kirsty! Me first! No! Me!
No, me first! No!
Me!
No! Stop it! Me! He's getting away!
No! Ow!
Dylan's advice, take one! Hayden.
Hey, gorgeous. Awesome outfit. Really flatters your rockin' bod.
Gorgeous, that awful outfit really flattens your porkin' bod.
Huh?
Not cool!
You idiot!
You idiot? I mean, I'm an idiot for saying flattens when I meant flatters. You know, it's a good thing.
Ethan, no offense, but I'm kind of busy. Is there something you wanted to ask me?
Yes.
The safari party! The safari party!
The safari party! The safari party!
What about it?
Did you know that it's this weekend?
Mm-hmm.
Just checking. See ya.
Nice going, Romeo.
Royale! A potential date!
Hey, Slick Fox here. I'm tall, dark, handsome, and looking for a love connection.
Hi, I'm pretty in pink, and...
Well, now what do I say?
I want a guy who's, like, handsome, tall, athletic, and likes to buy me things. And works in a juice bar. Brag about your good points.
Quick, hide the book! Mother of Pink, where's that dating article?
We're working on it, see?
Well, hurry up, I need it! I mean...
Your thing needs it. Brag about your good points. Hi, Slick Fox. It's me again, pretty in pink. I'm tall, naturally blonde and beautiful, and... that's just for starters.
Cool. I'm 25. How old are you?
31. Oops. Let's see. 25. Ah, close enough.
I can't believe we blew up 100 balloons.
I did serious damage to my puckering muscles.
No. You're way too tense. Look at the walk-alyzer readout. Jaw's too tight. Obviously, you're thinking about it too much. Droopy shoulders shows lack of confidence. Clenched fists. You're supposed to be a lover, not a fighter. And you're walking on your tiptoes. Are you a ballerina? Are you in stealth mode? Is the floor too hot? Check it out. You gotta ooze confidence. Talk the talk, walk the walk. Do the deal, man, swagger. Excuse me, the master's at work here.
Sorry.
Awesome. Let's go for it, dude. Ladies, a stud is born.
Goodbye, Dylan.
The parents, they bust her loose.
Quick! Let's get those jailbirds back in their cages. Chloe, these parrots are wrecking everything. We've got to get rid of them.
I've tried, but even the zoo doesn't want them.
Want them! Want them!
Dylan's bad advice, take two.
This poem is just not happening.
Like, hey.
Now pose and turn around. Today's your lucky day, cause you and the E-Man, that's me, are going to the hottest party this side of the sun Saturday night.
The sun's really hot, and so is the party Saturday. Me, E-Man. You, Jane?
Are you asking me out?
Would you listen to me?
Quit talking so fast!
Are you asking me out?
No, not you. Yes.
New plan. We're going for the strong, silent type. So shut up and impress her with your strength.
Yasmin, watch this.
Ethan, what are you doing?
Slipping a disc.
Oh my gosh.
Ooh, that's gotta hurt.
Are you okay?
Fine. It only hurts when I walk. there's a safari party Saturday. I thought maybe...
You know, I'd like to go, but this poem is due on Monday.
Oh, okay. I got it.
But if I get done in time, well, maybe.
Maybe? Okay. So it's a definite maybe. See ya. Oh! Oops. I'm still at work.
Oh, hi, Eden. I can do the bump.
A big bump. I can do a bigger bump.
Move, Klutzy.
Dylan's really bad advice, take three.
Girls dig expensive gifts, so you gotta seal the deal by getting her some major bling.
Oh, yeah, right. On a waiter's tips?
Okay, so maybe it doesn't have to be major bling.
Every little thing I've ever wanted. Everything you are now, and all I wanna be is here with you. Yeah, I wanna be the one to make you happy. So let me show you how I'll forever be faithful and true. I just want the real you. So come on, let me show you how I feel too.
So, Eaton, how's the article coming?
Oh, great. I got a definite maybe.
You got less than 6 hours to the party. Dude, we're pulling out the heavy artillery. The kind I usually reserve for asking out seniors.
Come on, Dylan. The only senior you've ever gone out with is your grandmother.
Eaton. It's time to flaunt the big bucks under her nose and tell her you know Orlando Bloom.
Actually, it's time to try something else. Something called doing it my way.
I hope it works. Otherwise, your magazine article is gonna be one big snooze.
Speaking of the magazine, editorial meeting in 20.
I'll call Yasmin and Warner. She's using our pad to work on her poem.
The waves wash away living history on stone. The seagulls scatter. My love stands alone. The sun is gone, the moon.
The baby's coming, I face it. Just come out and say it. 'Cause I wanna make it happen and I can't hold back my passion. Does she feel what I feel inside? Like I feel when I'm with her.
You're right, you are crazy. And you're wearing me down. Okay, I'll go to the party with you.
You will?
Yes, but leave the ladies' room now.
Does she feel what I feel inside?
Eaton only asked you out because of the article.
Yeah.
What article?
The article he's writing for Bratz magazine about how to get a girl to go out with you. Didn't your friends tell you?
People, let's focus on our next article.
Focus!
Cooking pizza with barbecued parrots?
Pizza!
Hey, pretty princess.
Don't pretty princess me. I found out about the Eaton article.
Scorching idea, right?
No, not scorching at all. How could you let Eaton do this to me? I thought we were friends.
We are, pretty princess.
Some friends.
Yasmin must be Eaton's crush.
Uh-oh.
Why do they call you Slick Fox?
'Cause I'm as slick as I am foxy.
Here's our article on how to get a guy to ask you out. Give me that. Why are you still here? Out, chop chop.
Do you think our dating advice works? I mean, like, we don't have any dates.
That's only because you wasted all that time going after Eaton when he so obviously liked Yasmin.
You thought he liked you too.
Uh-uh, I said Cameron liked me.
What do you do for fun?
Stick pins in Bratz voodoo dolls.
Oops, better delete that. Date man with movie star looks.
Well, I got the looks. How about we get together Saturday night so you can check them out? I'll be in black.
Ew!
I'll be in pink.
Oh, man. After following Dylan's advice, you're lucky Yasmin hasn't taken out a restraining order against you. Yasmin! Hey, what time should I pick you up for the party?
Not only am I not going to the party with you, I never want to see you again.
Wait, why?
Or speak to you.
Hi, Cameron. I so like your socks.
Well, I so like your shirt.
I can name all the characters on My Life to Live.
I can make a milkshake come out of my nose.
Ugh! I'm out of here.
I'm wearing him down.
Come on, let's call her.
Left alone, but tears can't rewrite the past.
Yasmin? it's Eaton.
I said I never want to speak to you again, even if there's a door between us.
Then just listen. Your friends didn't know you were the one I was asking out. They'd never set you up like that. And neither would I.
Just go write your article and leave me alone.
Not till I'm finished. Look, I've liked you since you walked into the juice bar last summer and corrected my spelling of pomegranate. But I was too nervous to ask you out. And Dylan offered to help.
You took advice from Dylan?
Yes! That's how much I wanted to take you to the party. Will you open the door now? Just a crack?
Oh no! My paper palm trees are going to wilt in the rain! All this work going down the drain, not to mention my outfit, my hair, my mascara!
What are we gonna do?
Cab jungle, we'll travel.
The sun is gone, the moon has yet to rise. My past vanishes in my beloved eyes? But that doesn't really make sense.
Well, let me think. Oh, how about his love for me fades with the vanilla skies?
Eaton, that's beautiful. Thanks. Yasmin!
Eaton!
You're talking to each other.
Pretty princess, we are so sorry.
We had no idea Eaton was crushing on you.
I know, Eaton's explained everything. I'm sorry too. I should have known you guys wouldn't betray me like that.
Got me! Got me!
Hello, Slick Fox.
Pretty in Pink.
Tall, dark, and handsome?
Tall, naturally blonde, and beautiful?
25!
I won't tell if you won't.
Fine.
Double Trouble just walked in.
What are they doing here?
I've got it covered.
I can't believe we didn't get dates.
And we're like so much more gorgeous than everyone here.
You're just in time.
So, like, where's our party favors?
Yeah.
Oh, we have special ones just for you.
Wow, these birds are like so beautiful and lifelike.
Yeah.
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 Hey, Yasmin, wanna dance?
And that is how I became the subject of Eaton's Bratz magazine article titled How Not to Ask a Girl Out. Everybody's